Hey.
Canadian chips are incredible.
We have received, Kenny's segments are like potato chips. You can't enjoy just one.
No, you can't. I'll tell you what, Heartfield, you do a wonderful job, man.
Okay.
Very good.
You guys are trying them.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, we're here at the heart of, tell me what you think. I want you guys to try them.
Okay.
You know, don't get your fingers too greasy on the laptop. But we're here at Heartfield Potato Chips, so this is great. So I'm hanging out with you guys now. Anthony, you get about, each bin is about 2,000 pounds.
Yep,
each worth of these, right?
Yep.
And then you have to keep them at literally about 50 degrees.
Around 50, 51 degrees, because if they get too hot, they start to go bad. If they get too cold, they start to go bad. And that 50, 51 degrees is the temperature that the potatoes are stored when they're in the ground growing.
Gotcha.
So you want to keep them at that constant temperature.
Okay, and so we see here's the bin, they get dumped in here. Now what happens here?
So right now what's happening is the potatoes are in the peeler. And what we're doing is we're weighing them for the gravity. So when Kenny, you know, said we've got 2,000 pounds of potatoes,
yeah,
we're getting roughly 20% of each potato to become a chip. And right now it's weighing that, it peels them, and then it's coming out clean. This is the only time during the whole process where we're actually cleaning and washing our potatoes. We like to keep as much of that starch and sugar taste into the potato, so as we're cooking them, they've got a distinct kind of old world flavor to them.
Gotcha. So only 20% of the potato makes it as a chip.
20%.
All right, so they come up here, right, Anthony? They
Correct.
Come up here next, and then this is where they get sliced.
This is our slicer right here, and so it's slicing and throwing the potatoes into the fryer right now, where they're gonna cook for roughly 5 minutes at 325 degrees.
Okay, so the slicing happens, now they're clean, they get sliced, and then they get put into the cooker. So what is he doing with the...
Correct, so right now, what Carl is doing is Carl is agitating them, keeping the potato chips separate from each other so that they don't clump, because if you get clump potato chips, while they taste really good, they also become really hard, so we wanna keep them separated. And now the robotic arm is transferring back and forth, and it's agitating the chips.
Gotcha.
That's how you get the curls and the bubbles, all the different distinct looks that you get in a kettle-style potato chip that you don't get from a continuous cooker that some of the big companies
do. So that's keeping them separate and letting them, you know, the anti-clumper is what we could call it, right?
The anti-clumper. We're going to rename it right now. I like that.
Awesome. All right, so we're gonna let this batch cook. This is phase one. We're gonna let this batch cook and then we're gonna explain what happens next. Now, but back in the day, before we had the anti-clumper, there was a guy with a...
Usually there'd be 2 to 3 people here with rakes just continuously stirring and separating the chips.
They probably had Popeye forearms, man.
They were some big guys. Real little bodies, real big arms.
All right, awesome. Heartfield potato chip. You start with this and it turns into a potato chip. How are you guys liking the potato chips so far? They're pretty tasty, right?
They're so good.
Can I tell you, this is a crump opportunity extraordinaire.
I figured you would like them.
He loves his potato chips.
All right, we're going back to you guys. We have some more potato chips to make.
All right,
with the
anti-clumper.
They're really, really good. Mm.